so exciting to hear the wonderful testimonies. The testimonies of what the Lord is doing. If there is something that we need to know that God is real.
That's right.
God is real. God is alive.
That's right.
And because He is alive, you and I can face tomorrow.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So we want to thank God that today you took your time to come. And you took your time to come to our first service after our grand opening. And we are believing God for great things in this place.
Amen.
We are believing God for great things in this city.
Right.
We are believing God for a great move of God.
Right.
We are believing God that more bondages will be broken.
Yeah.
We are believing God that more healings will take place.
Yeah.
We are believing God that more liberation will take place. We are believing God that many lives will be turned around for the glory of God. For the glory of God.
Amen.
Let's quickly open our Bibles to the book of Isaiah 43. I just want to be quick and catch time. You people, you are wonderful. Thank you for taking your time to be with us this morning.
Amen.
And I know that you'll never regret walking into this place.
No way.
Because God is here this morning. Amen. God is here. 43. The book of Isaiah 43, I will read verse 18 and 19. Isaiah 43, verse 18 to 19. Forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the desert and streams in the wasteland. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God inspires us to have hope, hope in our Lord Jesus. Many of us believers, we are bound. Like what my brother is saying, we are bound in the shame of the past. We are bound in offense of the past. Somebody has offended me in the past. And I cannot get past it. My life lives in a prison of bondage. The bondage of the past. The bondage of past. Sexual immorality, past guilty. But here is what the word of God says today. Forget ye the former things, for Christ is doing a new thing in your life. Forget it.
Hallelujah.
One cannot move forward unless one forgets the mistake of their past. Unless one can look up to Christ. Unless one can believe God. That the mistake I made yesterday, Christ has forgiven me.
Amen.
Now there is a new hope. The new hope is that I can face tomorrow.
Amen.
Because Jesus Christ himself is alive.
That's right.
Tell your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Tell your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Forget what happened to you in the past. Forget your past failure. Forget your past yes. Your past sickness. For Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, is doing something new in our life. He's doing something new in our life. And I want to declare to you this morning, prophetically, that this is your new beginning. It is a new day for you. And your life will never be the same again. You will never be the same again. I want you to know Christ has come to set you free. Christ has come to liberate you and me and set us free. And set us on a pedestal where we can do the impossible. Remember this. The Bible says, do not dwell. Don't dwell on the past. Don't dwell about what happened many years ago. Don't dwell on what people have done to you. Don't dwell on the challenges you faced yesterday. Tomorrow is new. Come on, Asapa, tomorrow is new. And I want you to declare that today is a new day for you. It's a new beginning for you. How do we receive the things of God? We receive the things of God by faith. By faith. By faith. When I was a young boy at the age of 22 years old, I was in law school at that time, training to become a lawyer at that time, and I got sick, real sick, and I was in pain every day of my life, I was in pain. Then one day I happened to have gone to the doctor, and from the doctor took me to a specialist doctor, and I started knocking the doors of neurosurgeons, specialists, and I said, what's wrong with me? When I met the neurosurgeon, he said to me, listen to me, you are lucky that you are alive. Many people who have the kind of disease you have today, would have died already at the age of 18. You are 22. I thank God. My brother who was with me turned around and said, do not be afraid. The wishes of your enemies will not kill you. And from that day, I began to believe God that I could live a long life. I began to believe God that I could be healed. I began to believe God that things will turn up around again. And I want to tell you, now I am completely free from that disease. Jesus Christ healed me and set me free. For his glory, I have lived much way. Oh my God, much way more than that. So I want to thank God. Listen to me. Jesus is real. Tonight and today, Jesus is real. No matter the mountain, Jesus is able to move your mountain. No matter the challenge you have, Jesus is able to move that mountain and that challenge. The Bible tells us that the thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus declared prophetically, I came that they may have life and have it in abundance. So I want to declare abundant life over your life today in the name of Jesus. Amen. I said that your life will never be the same again. You don't have to worry about the past failure of yesterday. Yesterday is gone. Today is present.
That's right.
Tomorrow is a reality. We live because of Christ. We move because of him. All the time I say to him, you are my all in all. You are my all in all. Without you, I'll fall. Without you, I cannot stand. You are my all in all. And we want to declare today that Brantford is for Jesus Christ. Brantford belongs to Jesus Christ. Brantford is for Jesus. You are not in this place because of an accident. No, your being here this morning is by divine purpose, by divine appointment. And we know, I want to assure you, within the next few weeks, you are going to see us moving from glory to glory, from glory to glory, from glory to glory. Many lives are going to change. I am sure about that, very sure about that. When we started the church in the city of Hamilton, when we started the church there, we were only four people, myself, my wife, and my two children. What angered us was our faith in Jesus Christ. We knew that God is real.
That's right.
We knew that God is faithful. We knew that God is what is dependable. Amen. And we kept on going together as a family. We kept on believing God. Together as a people, we kept on working together. And suddenly, a miracle happened. And the environment has changed.
Amen.
We have seen people who fly all the way from Alberta to come for prayer. We have seen people who fly all the way from the United States of America to come for prayer. And we have seen healings taking place. We have seen the power of God taking place within our midst. And I want to tell you, God is here. All what we have to do is let's position ourselves. We want to position ourselves not because of what happened yesterday. We want to position ourselves today in the hope that we have through Jesus Christ. When we position ourselves, you are the next evangelist. You are the next woman of God. You are the next man of God. You just go out and begin to witness Christ. As you witness Christ, the power of God will descend in our midst. It will descend in our midst. So I want to encourage you. I know. I want to encourage you. I lived a life. Myself, when God healed me, after he healed me, I forgot about him. When I forgot about him, I started drinking. I started going around doing things that did not please God. And I fell into deep sin. But one day, while I was in my sin, I felt very uncomfortable about where I was. And I remember I went into a park. And I said, Jesus, if you are there, I cannot rescue myself. Save me. Redeem me. And let me tell you, I have been free for over 24 years. I have been free. Free of the bondage of sexual immorality. Free from the bondage of alcoholism. Who has done that? It's him. Amen. Who has the power to change situations. He has set you free. So you are talking to a man who was at the very deep end of life. I didn't know what to do with my life. I didn't know how to stop what was happening in my life. But one day Jesus came for me. And I declare that one day Jesus Christ, our Savior, will come for you. He will come for you. Today, if you open up your heart, he is there for you. And your life will never be the same again. Your life will never be the same again. And from there, I began to go to church slowly by slowly. There were things I didn't understand, but I just kept on going. There are things I had questions about, but I just kept on going. As I kept on going, I discovered the chains were being broken every day. As I heard the word of God, the chains were broken every day. I became freer and freer until today. And I gave up my job, my career as a lawyer, to become a pastor. And I love what I do, because what I do is for the glory of God. Hallelujah. So there is hope for you. There is hope for your life. All what you need to do, forget about the past. Forget about where you are coming from. Where you are coming from is not important. Where you are going is important. So forget where you are coming from. Forget your mistake. Forget your weakness. Now trust in God and believe in God. The Bible says, with faith all things are possible if we believe. And I usually say faith laughs at the impossible. What seems impossible with men is possible with God. So your God can do it for you. My God can do it for you. Our God can do it for you. He can take it out of our life. He can change everything for his own glory. And I want to tell you, as we declare here, we know that this church will be full. Full of people that are hungry for God. Full of people that love God. Full of people who want to go somewhere. We want to declare that this city of Brantford will never be the same again. We are praying for the north of Brantford, that the north of Brantford will yield to God. The south of Brantford will yield to God. The west will yield to God. The center will yield to God. Hallelujah. So be encouraged in the Lord. One day, when David came from battle, he went back home. When he went back home, he got there, he discovered his wives had been taken away, his possessions had been taken away, everybody. And everybody turned around and began to accuse David. And the Bible says that they spoke like that. David began to encourage himself in the Lord. As he encouraged himself in the Lord, he began to have strength, more courage. And he went after those who had taken up what? Taken up his family. And he was able to redeem them. So I want to declare that whatever you lost, God will redeem it for you. Whatever was happening in your life, that was negative. And today we reverse that. And we declare that by the blood of Jesus, your life will never be the same again. Your life will never be the same again. Your life will never be the same again. And let me tell you this. I always challenge the believers. When we come together, let us come together in the love of God. Love is a cure of the past. Love is a cure of present hurts. Love is a cure of future hurts. Love. If we come in love, there's nothing God cannot do among us. The Bible says how pleasant and good it is when brothers dwell together in unity. It is like the oil poured on the head of Aaron, coming down to his beard, even unto the hem of his garments. There, God will bestow blessing and life forevermore. I am what I am because of you. You are what you are because of me. So as together, as a team, we want to do great things for Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Great things for Jesus Christ. Let me wound up by opening the scripture again with the book of Romans. A very familiar passage of scripture. Let's go there. Oh my God. Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. The book of Romans 8. We are going to read verse 28, and we will jump to read verse 37. So we'll read verse 8, and we will connect verse 8 and verse 37. So, and we know that in all things, God works for good, for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. 37. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
No trouble will come your way. No challenge will come our way that will be able to separate us from the love of God. And I want to declare that whatever you have been going through, whatever the situation, you are more than a conqueror. You are more than a conqueror. You are more than a conqueror. I say you are more than a conqueror. In all these things, you are more than a conqueror. Do not be discouraged. Jesus has offered you hope. Do not be discouraged. Jesus is ever present for you. The Bible calls him an ever present help in times of need. So we are going somewhere.
That's right.
Remember, every cathedral like this one began with the laying of one brick. Every journey starts with one step of faith. The question is, are we willing to keep on going forward for Jesus Christ?
Amen.
And I know that we are willing. And I know that we are willing. I know that I am willing. We are willing to make a sacrifice to turn around, number one, our lives for the glory of God. Number two, to turn around the city of Brantford for the glory of God. Number three, to turn around the nation of Canada for the glory of God. For the glory of God. For the glory of God. I am so excited. Today we lay a new brick here.
Amen.
We begin a new journey, an exciting journey. Why? Because we know we are not on our own. We know that God is with us. God is with us. Let love flow in your heart. That's me. Love is what I crave for. Love is what I crave for. Love conquers hatred. Love conquers challenges and weaknesses. When we love one another, there's nothing God cannot do among us. I do not want to preach without love. I do not want to give without love. I do not want to stand without love. Because he himself, the Bible says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever who believe in him will not perish, but will have eternal life.
Amen.
We thank God for eternal life.
Amen.
We thank God for his love for you and me. Amen?
Amen.
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 I am a product of his love. You are a product of his love. We are a product of his love. And I believe this. I believe God wants us to become a family.
That's right.